Okay, what can engineers do when they come to Canada?
Well, they are special. They can become anything. Even if they want to become a prime minister, that's possible too.
Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel, and today we will be talking about Aman's journey as an engineer in Canada. So let's get started.
So as you all know, because of coronavirus, the way it's spreading so fast around the world, many people in the entire world they are practicing social distancing, and the government's also promoting people to stay home and make sure that they are not in crowded places. We've been working from home from past week or so, and today we just came out to see that if there is a possibility that we can get some fresh air and avoid meeting a lot of people and going into crowded places. As you can see around us, we're in a park, and
there are not a lot of people, and
yes,
even if they are like standing away from each other.
Yeah, so the Canadians are kind of doing a good job keeping themselves away, keeping them from isolated, and this is what we need to do to stop the spread.
Okay Aman, why and when did you come to Canada?
I came to Canada in 2010. The reason was not that I'm a Punjabi and I'm going to Canada. Jana. The reason was a recession. I did my engineering from Guru Nanak Dev Engineering College, Ludhiana, from 2005 to 2009. When we graduated in 2009, there were many companies who hired the engineers, but because of the recession, they did not give them the placement. So I was one of them, but I started working with Dell Computers as a technical support, which kind of helped me in improving my communication skills. And one weekend when I was back at home with my dad in Ludhiana, we went to see one of his friends who was a travel agent, and he kind of sprung the idea that you can actually go study in this time, and he applied for my student visa in Humber College.
Okay, so you studied in Humber College. So tell us how your experience was.
Humber College is one of the better colleges we have in Ontario. The four biggest colleges, or four best colleges according to me, is George Brown, Humber, Centennial and Seneca. And the decision to come to Humber College was not mine. As I said, that my dad's friend was a travel agent, and he selected that college for me. And he gave me an option to choose either computer science or global business management. The reason I didn't choose computer science is that I was already graduate as an engineer. I did not want to do the same thing again. So I chose to come here and study in global business management, which was a 2-year postgraduate program. Humber College itself has two campuses. One is North Campus, another one is Lakeshore Campus. And the Lakeshore Campus is right next to a lake. It's beautiful. And we used to go to the lake pretty much every day after the classes. And study-wise, they are very serious. And if you are coming to Humber College, you'll be surprised. It's a pretty good college.
Okay, so did you work part-time when you were studying?
Yes, in the last semester, I got a job with a company which used to sell water tanks. Since Canada is a very cold country most time of the year, there are two necessities every household should have before anybody can live in it. The first one is heat, the second one is hot water. So that got me introduced into this world of heating and cooling. And the part-time job was, I was working three days a week, and I was going to school 4 days a week. So it was pretty packed schedule.
When you were working part-time, was that money enough for you to survive?
Honestly, when I started my part-time job, I was getting paid about $12 an hour. At that time, the minimum wage was $10.15. But $12 an hour was in no way sufficient. So thank you to my dad. He helped me through my schooling. He kind of took care of all the expenses. And that's why I'm in a good place right now.
What were your options after you graduated?
For an engineer, the biggest thing which anybody can do is go get their P.eng license. Unlike India, when you graduate from an engineering college, you are considered an engineer. It's not the same in Canada. In Canada, if you want to practice engineering, you have to go through a process called P.eng, Professional Engineers. It's a little bit different all across Canada in different provinces, but in Ontario, you have to get licensed as a P.eng. You have to have engineering graduation or master's, a certain amount of experience, and then you can apply to them. And once they see that you have enough experience and education to become an engineer, in certain occasions they will ask you to write a test. But once you are done with that, they will give you the certification of a P.eng, and then only you will be able to call yourself an engineer in Canada and stamp the drawings or any work you do. It's not really the case that you always have to have a P.eng to work as an engineer in Canada. You can get a job as an engineer, but you cannot stamp your drawings. Many people who come to Canada who do not have enough experience to apply for their P.eng license, they work under an engineer, and after a certain period of time, with the experience they get, they can apply for P.eng later on. So it's not like that you have to have a P.eng to work as an engineer. You can work as a trainee engineer under a P.eng. So the third and the final option is the option I chose. I did not end up going for my P.eng because the industry I chose to work was in HVAC, heating and cooling. And throughout the years, I gradually increased the level of experience I have and the certifications I need to work in this industry. So I never felt the need to go back to do my P.eng. Even though I'm an electronics engineer, most of the work I do is in mechanical engineering field. See, it's pretty much empty around here. The social distancing at its best.
Yeah, even if we are seeing people are trying to maintain a distance.
Yeah, see, there are a couple of people over there walking their dog. They're pretty far from us. You see, summertime in Canada is always glorious. What usually happens is there are lots of parks around wherever you live, and there are picnic areas like this. So you can come out and do your barbecue. Yeah, bring your food, do barbecue, and there's a lot of areas to play. So in the summertime, people are going to play soccer, volleyball, and cricket. Sometimes cricket as well.
Okay, why did you choose HVAC?
There are two basic reasons. One, since this is a very cold country, it doesn't matter if there is a recession or not, HVAC work never stops. People always need heating, people always need hot water. The second is I love problem solving, and in the job I am in right now, I do problem solving from the start of the day to the end of the night.
Okay, tell us about your job experience.
When I started working part-time, the first job I got was door-to-door sales. It was pretty difficult, but it kind of toughens me up. And I worked with the company for about 3 years, and then they decided to sell the company to a bigger company. And then after that, I started working with the residential HVAC company, where I learned about managing that company, doing more sales, which gave me enough experience to move to my next position in a commercial company. And during that time, I got 2 licenses, which are very helpful to progress in the HVAC industry. And I'll speak to you about that license in another video. And right now I'm working with a manufacturer, very big manufacturer in HVAC industry. They have offices all over the world. They have one office in Bangalore. Yeah, they're a multinational. They have one office in Bangalore as well. I started with them about 8 months ago as a service supervisor. But last week, as she knows, I gave her a party, I got promoted, I'm now the manager saab. Achha, aap sab ne Ram Setu to dekha hoga. Ye dekho, Canada mein bhi Ram Setu banaya ja raha hai.
What have you learned in this 9 years while working in Canada?
The first thing I'd say is a lot of people make a mistake. They think that to get a job in Canada, you need a lot of experience. It's not like that. The biggest thing you need is confidence, and you need a resume which is tailored to the job application.
Okay, in the previous video you mentioned about tailoring the resume. What do you mean by that?
What basically happens is when you apply for any job, before the resume goes to a hiring manager or your HR, they put it through a software which searches your resume with keywords. If they match with the job posting, then they will shortlist it. If not, then it's very unlikely that your resume will end up with somebody who is capable to do the hiring decisions. So the other important thing I learned is many times it happens that you're not able to get a job in the field you've been working back home. But don't get discouraged or disheartened if that happens to you. Take the job, prove yourself, and very likely it's going to happen is that the field you get in may end up becoming better than the previous field you were in. That's the case in my situation. I graduated as an electronics engineer, but when I came here, I started my work in heating and cooling. Gradually, I got all the licenses which I need to become successful in this field and learned the tips and the tricks of the trade, and ended up being in a position where now I am managing the global service department of a big manufacturing company.
Okay, now the most important question: how much does an engineer make and how much do you make?
Usually what happens is that in the beginning your jobs as an engineer starts at around like $50,000 to $70,000 a year, but as you progress in your career, it's easily you'll be able to make between $100,000 and $125,000 a year. At my position where I am right now, my salary is between $80,000 to $100,000 a year. That's a good enough money.
Okay, to summarize, in the starting you can just get whatever job you can get, and then get your license and apply for the suitable job and then be successful.
Alright, so if you like the information we have given in this video, please like the video, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon. We try to post at least one or two videos a week, and if you want to be involved in that process, make sure you hit the
notification
icon. Thank you very much.